as I say that. Really? Okay. He wants to put a knight on d4. I think I faced something like this before. Somebody played this against me recently. In like a tournament or something. I'm trying to remember where. Odd that he should be able to open everything up and have it be good for him. Maybe knight a4. I don't know. Nah, knight a4 is a little bad. A little bad. Here, I've got to deal with e4. Threatening that one, eh? He is threatening that one. Well, that's actually quite annoying, isn't it? Because bishop a6 can be played anyway. Bishop a6. Bishop a6 can probably be played here. I would play bishop a6 if I was him. Looks like a good one. Looks like a good move. Still think I can try. Still think we can try here. My idea is to play the knight f5 work. Knight f5, he just takes it, and then I would lose my rook anyway. Knight f5 gets my knight out of the way, but doesn't actually save my rook, so I didn't think it helped. But I went this way so that I thought I'm getting the bishop back here. It's an annoying move for sure. Thank you. going on here? Gotta be quite careful, of course. Wanna get rook c8 in. Rook c8's really important. His position with two rooks on the board and a bishop maybe is tricky, but if I trade off one of them, then it's just winning. King is never in danger with just a rook and a bishop. Hey Chris, how's it going? Thanks for tuning in, bud. Glad you still appreciate the channel after seeing it in person, you know? Some people, once they get a glimpse, it's like, okay, it's enough for me. Play some suspicious stuff. Let's go here. Frost, 197, 11 months. 11 months. What's up, man? Almost at the year. Appreciate the support. Five or not. Thought he was going to go for D5 there. H5. I want to put a knight on d5. I think it's quite strong there. Maybe bishop f8 if necessary to defend that guy. But I really like knight d5 as a move. Probably h5. Yeah, so he can take and take here, but I think I actually want to let him do that. Surprisingly. Like, I want to give him the two rooks, because I think that I can get good counterplay with my pieces. Yeah, so like I said, bishop f8 to defend that. Let's just do this. I don't care if he doubles, because he can't really go anywhere in that file. I'm trying to hold the fort with this knight. I also got maybe like knight d7 or something soon. To loosen up his king position. Yeah, definitely want to take that. I thought he should have played g3 and then gone knight f4. I don't really like that move by him. He can ruin my pawns here, but I got like knight h4 to f3 coming, so yeah, he's gonna take that one. Probably rook to h7 here is a good idea. yet. I'm just gonna go rook to h7, queen h5. I think that's a big move. d5, I'm just gonna ignore it, rook h7. Almost any move, I think I ignore it. Any threat, let's say, like I'm obviously hanging a pawn here, but I'm gonna ignore that too. So he wants h3 on queen h5. Oh, I didn't even see that, actually. Didn't see that one. I'll probably go here and here. I'm hitting the bishop here. If he goes back, probably go d5. Had a feeling he might miss that. Just had this feeling. Okay, here. Trying to remember something, some weird line that I looked at, but wasn't remembering anything. I think he's supposed to go for a setup a little different than this, but okay. This looks a little artificial. F5, I don't think it works. But taking with your king on f8, I know that's already wrong. And this pawn is pinned. Obviously, you got that threat. You might want to play like e6 or something, just to not open the position up too much. Knight there, I got bishop e4. Maybe I want to bring the queen out here. Queen g4, queen h5 next. Just get the pieces out. Yeah, so here probably queen g4. Threatens this pawn, and also threatens bishop g5 and rook f1. Once the pieces get, I mean, you can see he can barely develop here. His knight on e8 is like trapped. Doesn't look good for him. Probably should not take. Let's keep the queens on. This is still pinned. Thinking about taking, bringing the rook over. Just take that. If he takes with a... Wow, okay. Played that pretty quickly. This should work. I mean, I don't know. Instincts. This has to work. If he lets me play knight f5, it's also over, so I think he's gonna take queen g7. But rook there, I don't know. Should be enough. Got queen d8 too. Got queen d8. Hey, distant fire. Tommy, what's up, buddy? Jesus, what a fucking move. What a move. So this move threatens knight e7. The knight still hit, so yeah, knight d7 doesn't make a lot of sense. Oh, guess he's in another game. That looked very suspicious by him. I mean, first of all, when you play this, that was like a less than 20 move win. When you play this line, the only way to play as black is to go for c6 and d5, as far as I know. So you get the theory that goes like something like this. So this is some theoretical position. But surprisingly, when black goes for like d6 and it almost looks good, like, you know, playing on the dark squares and got a nice square for your knight. But the problem is that this pawn structure is pretty much unassailable. Okay, I'll stop b5. You can't do anything to these pawns, and I just castle, play f. I just like storm the kingside with pawns. In practice, that's usually just, I don't know, very, very hard to play with black.